Hirokawa Maru and Kinugawa Maru were both cargo ships that were requisitioned by the Imperial Japanese Army during World War II. The Hirokawa was built by Kawasaki and launched for use on May 10, 1940. It was requisitioned by the Army on February 8, 1941 and converted into an anti-aircraft vessel. The Kinugawa was built by Mitsubishi and launched in 1939. It was requisitioned by the Army in 1941 for armed transport. On November 15, 1942, at 4 a.m., both vessels were beached by the Japanese to unload supplies and troops from the vessels. At 5:55 a.m., they started being bombarded by the Americans. Americans managed to destroy most of the equipment not already unloaded. Both vessels were badly broken up, and today coral and other marine life have mostly taken them over. The Hirokawa has its bow in shallow water while its stern is down at about 55 meters, and the Kinugawa has its bow actually above water with its stern at about 27 meters. The I-1 submarine was built by Kawasaki and commissioned by the Imperial Japanese Army on March 10, 1926. On January 29, 1943, the I-1 was detected off the coast of Guadalcanal by two corvettes, the HMNZS Kiwi and the HMNZS Moa. The Kiwi and Moa dropped depth charges on her, damaging her and forcing her to surface. A gun battle ensued. The Kiwi then rammed her three times, damaging itself in the process. Once the Kiwi had to back out due to its damages, the Moa chased her down till she ran aground. When the I-1 ran aground, it was abandoned and sank. The Japanese realized code books, charts, and other secret documents were left aboard, so the Imperial Japanese Army returned on February 2nd to try and destroy it by dropping depth charges on it. This was unsuccessful, so on February 10th, they tried to destroy it by air. This was also unsuccessful. On February 13th, the I-2 sub tried to destroy it, but couldn't locate it in the dark. The documents were eventually recovered by the Americans. Now its hull is torn open, allowing divers to swim along inside of it. Its stern is about 25 meters, and its bow is at about 10 meters. Thank you. White Beach was a code name for an American military base. When the troops departed at the end of the war, everything was just shoved on into the water. Trucks, jeeps, tractors, and assorted other military debris are still down there today. Mavis was the Allied name for the Kawanishi H-6K flying boats. They had four engines and twin tails. Mavis 5 is believed to be the best preserved of the flying boats. Its nose is crumpled from its initial impact, however, the rest of the aircraft is in good shape. Avis 6 was badly damaged. It broke in half and had its wings torn off. The cockpit is open, so nowadays divers can poke inside. The consolidated PBY Catalinas were the American version of the flying boats. There were two engine amphibious aircrafts. This particular one sank in 1943 after hitting a small boat. Thank you. Funabutu Wharf was a concrete wharf that both the Americans and the Japanese used throughout the war. Similar to White Beach, it has a large amount of debris all throughout the area. One of my favorite things there was the landing craft.